We interrupt this program to bring you breaking news. For the first time, we're hearing from the father of a young boy rescued from a burning SUV in Milwaukee. That harrowing rescue was caught on tape Sunday. 4-year-old David Harper is recovering from severe burns at Children's Hospital. A news conference is going on right now. Let's listen in.
I wanted to do this news conference to thank all of the community, the entire community, for the outpouring of support. However, please respect their wishes that they want to do the news conference, but not individual interviews afterwards. So again, we'll be doing questions at the end. And I'd like now to introduce the father of David Harper, James Chris Harper.
Hello, how are y'all doing? Good afternoon. My name is James Harper. I'm a DJ's dad. I can't express the gratitude that me and my wife have for the city of Milwaukee. First, I want to take a minute to thank the firefighters and all the brave citizens that helped get my son out of the vehicle, especially John and Joe Reckless, the brothers that got my son out of the vehicle. There's so many people at the scene, and I just want to express our gratitude. And how grateful we are. The words can't express how the citizens of Milwaukee have helped us so far. This is a wonderful place. They're in the best hospital that they have up here. And I just want to thank the staff, the hospital, and the citizens of Milwaukee and everybody. There's no words really that can express how grateful I am. I'm sorry. I'm trying to hold it together. It's my little boy, and I'm gonna turn it over to the doctors. But I just want to thank everybody for the citizens of Milwaukee for helping us. It's a wonderful. There are angels all around us, and I'd like to thank everybody.
Good afternoon. I'm David Gurley. I'm one of the pediatric surgeons here at Children's Hospital, and I have been involved in DJ's care as one of our members of the surgery group since he came into the hospital 2 days ago. And I'm one of many physicians and nurses and staff that have been helping to take care of DJ here in the hospital. And I just wanted to give, at his parents' request, an update on how DJ is doing and the extent of his injuries. DJ, I would say, is in serious condition but stable condition, and he has been resuscitated over the last few days from what are estimated to be about 20% of his body surface area that has burned, and much of that is deep to full thickness burns. And over the next few weeks, he will remain here in the ICU while he undergoes excision of his burns and grafting. And I anticipate that DJ will do very well from that, but also require several months here in the hospital doing rehabilitation from his burn injuries. DJ, I think, is very fortunate to have such loving parents who have clearly been here since the time he arrived and helpful to us. He has many members of his family that have also been here to help take care of him, and he's very fortunate for that. I'm happy to answer any questions if there are specific ones about his care.
Is it out of the life-threatening stage at this point?
Well, I believe so. We worry about burns in general, especially larger burns that are deep, in the sense that they're a potential source for infection. And so it's been standard practice in the United States and really throughout the world to do early excision of the burns that are full thickness and to begin grafting them, because that provides coverage. And so his biggest risk currently is that of infection, either in his burn wounds or related to his care in the hospital.
Is there a possibility for a full recovery here?
Oh, I believe DJ will make a full recovery. What's challenging with burns, especially deep burns that are extensive like DJ's, is the functional, the cosmetic, and the psychological recovery from that. Oh, definitely. Given the fact how deep his burns were when he presented, it indicates to me that this was a very hot fire and he was in close contact with them. And certainly it was, to some degree, a closed space fire. And although DJ didn't have any airway injury, there's a potential for smoke inhalation and airway injury the longer he's in there. And so these firefighters clearly were heroic and saved DJ's life. Well, one of the mainstays of early burn resuscitation is to stop the burning. And so they put him on the ground and smothered out the burns, which was very appropriate. And they were able to cool him down with the cold water and try and stop that burning process. We worry about cold water for extensive periods of time because it's very easy to get hypothermic. But that did not happen to DJ because they promptly covered him up and transported him. So they did a very good job in taking care of him in the early phases. That's a good question, and I don't think DJ fully understands it at this point in time because, one, as soon as he arrived here to Children's Hospital, we made the decision to go right from the emergency room to the operating room, mostly for his comfort, and one of our pediatric anesthesiologists, Dr. Campbelloff, anesthetized him and put a breathing tube in, and he's been heavily sedated in the ICU for his own comfort since that point in time, and so we haven't had a very good chance to talk to him about that. In talking to him, that will be a long-term process because it's very hard sometimes for four-year-olds to understand the extent of it. And in some degrees, we don't want him necessarily to remember all the things that are going to happen over the next few weeks. But we, as part of our burn treatment here at Children's Hospital and our comprehensive burn program, is child psychology. And they're an integral part of that, child life as well. And so that will be a gradual process over the next several months, and a very important part of his burn rehabilitation.
What portion of his body
did he sustain? It is most of his scalp. His face has less severe burns. The upper part of his back and most of his upper extremities and hands, and small portions of his lower extremities. No, fortunately not. Well, not so much relearn how to use them, but scarring is a part of the process of healing from burns. And even though he will have skin grafts, there's some contraction of the skin grafts themselves, which can leave harder for an individual to completely use their extremity, especially when burns cross the joints. And so physical therapy and occupational therapy and rehabilitation medicine are an important part of that. There's also a lot of pain involved, even after grafting, that limits function. And so it's not so much learning them, but it's regaining strength and regaining mobility after the burn. Yeah, most of his burns are third degree. There are some a smaller portion of his burn are what we would classify as second degree or indeterminate. That's a good question. It's very important in children that have been ill or injured to help the entire family. And so part of our psychology program here is not just isolated to the children, but to support the family as well. And so DJ's parents will be an important part of that. Obviously, they're grieving, their grieving process and their strength for DJ is very important to his overall outcome. Thank you very much.
Dr. Winthrop will stay if there are additional questions about our burn program. Dr. Gourlay covered a lot of the burn program pieces. So if there are any questions of the two physicians, they are still here. In any way that the public relations team can help you, let us know. Thank you.
And we've been listening into this news conference taking place at Children's Hospital. It has to do with that rescue, the SUV that was on fire Sunday, and all those people in the neighborhood on Milwaukee's south side that jumped in to pull this young boy, David Harper, 4 years old. We're hearing that his family calls him DJ, pulled David out of that vehicle, his mom and his younger sister as well. We heard from DJ's dad for the first time today since this happened, James Harper, expressing his gratitude to all the people here in Milwaukee. The family was in town from Tennessee for the Waukesha County Fair. He wanted to thank those off-duty firefighters who responded, jumped in, and pulled his child out, as well as everyone else there on the scene who helped to rescue his family. As he puts it, there are angels all around us. As for DJ, we're hearing from the doctor for the first time as well. He's in a serious condition but stable. He's in ICU. He'll likely stay in the hospital for several months. He has burns over 20% of his body. 20% of his body was burned. But the good news coming out of this is the doctor says he believes that DJ will make a full recovery. He just has a long road ahead of him. We do have continuing coverage on this. Stay with 12 News. We have team coverage on this later today right here on 12 News. Also on our website, WISN.com. We now send you back to programming.